Hello learners, welcome to the NIOS Studio program course code 509 entitled Learning in Social Science. I, Dr. Prerna Mandhyan, working as an assistant professor in Department of Education, DS College, Katihar. Today, we would discuss approaches to teaching geography and different domain of geography. Every subject has its own approaches to teach that subject. In the same way, geography has two main approaches to the teach geography. The first one is the systematic approach and the second one is the regional approach. In systematic approach, in this approach, a phenomena is studied as a whole. This is also known as topical approach, through which we study particular phenomena in detail and in holistic manner in a given region. For example, if we want to study any environmental variable like climate, then we have to study the climate, concept of climate, factors affecting the climate, climate types and regions of climate. This approach is called as systematic approach, while concerned to the second approach, and that is regional approach. In the regional approach, the world is divided into regions and different hierarchical levels. All the geographical phenomena in a particular region are studied. The phenomena in a region are studied in holistic manner, searching for unity in diversity. For example, if we want to study any region through regional approach, for example, region geography of our region or our state, then we have to study about their drainage pattern, communication system, road, transport system, trade, weather, climate, soil, all. This is called as a regional approach. Beside the above mentioned approaches, the main approaches of geography, there are other approaches which lead to the geography as an enjoyable and a real living subject. While concerning the other approaches, the first approach is learning through fieldwork. Fieldwork gives the opportunity to the students to the first hand investigate the real phenomena, the real natural phenomena. But teachers should be very restricted that the field work should not be limited to visits and guided tours, whereby passively students only listening, observing and note taking. Rather, field work should be inquiry based in line with aims and objectives of curriculum, where students enjoy the lively and real geography through the field work. It should involve students in identification of an issue or problem in a specific area, collect, present and analysis data, and finally identify possible solution and strategies. Learning through the field work, the teacher should try that the students learn themselves. The student learn to analyze the data, to collect the data and to present the data themselves. In this, concerning to the other approaches, the second approach is the learning through maps. Maps in the form of paper, digital images and globes are an important tool for teachers. It involves the simultaneous use of a number of concepts and skill, including aerial perspective, proportion, map language and arrangements. The teacher should make sure that students at least come to know about some mapping skills, that they could be draw, they could be highlight the point where the point is located in the map. In an inquiry based approach, students should have access to a wide range of maps, including large wall maps, atlas, globe, maps on CD-ROMs, on other electronic media, national ordnance surveys at various scales, and other media should be used to know or to make know about the maps to the students. The next approach is learning through IT. The geography teachers should aware their students the use of IT in geography. It could be mobile phone, it could be interactive whiteboard or the internet media. There can be different media through which we can study the geography. By the use of IT, teachers have the power to make lessons livelier and enjoyable, thus enhancing students' learning motivation. Specific programs for geography students such as Google Earth can improve spatial thinking, and electronic media and the internet enable students to get up-to-date information. It's up to the teachers how teacher make aware their students about the IT and the use of IT resources. The next approach to teach geography is learning through the use of games and simulations. At the upper primary level, the students or the kids are more enthusiastic about the games and the other role-playing models games. The philosophy underlying the use of games and simulations is in close harmony with inquiry-based approach to the teaching of geography. All the approaches we have studied earlier or we discussed earlier, they give a chance to students to come on the stage and perform, or we can say they learn the geography in their own way. Now, the domains of geography. If we consider geography as a social science subject, it is moreover about the natural sciences like meteorology, botany, zoology, chemistry, with other social science subjects like economics, political science, anthropology, philosophy, sociology, etc. In this way, we can say that geography is a multidisciplinary and interdisciplinary subject of study. So, the branches, or we can say the domains of geography, is a vast enough. Domains of geography are based on the systematic approach, the physical geography and the human geography. If we see, we can see through the picture that physical geography has connection to the many sciences like biology, ecology, chemistry, physics, engineering, hydrology, meteorology, oceanography, geology. While concerning to the human geography, it is more concerned to the social sciences like sociology, anthropology, economics, politics, philosophy, history, etc. Come to the physical geography. As we told earlier, that geography is more concerned about the natural sciences. So, here physical geography is mainly concerned with the environment variables like soil, climate, lands, etc., etc. On the basis of environmental variables, we can subdivide the physical geography on the following divisions. The first one is the geomorphology. Geomorphology is mainly concerned to the process of lands, evolution of lands and the designation of the lands. While concerning to the climatology, it studies about the structure of atmosphere, weather, climate and other factors that are related to the climate. Next, the hydrology, it concerning to the realm of water, other water bodies like river, canal and all the other water bodies which are concerning to the physiology or the physical geography. Next, the soil geography studies about the structure of soil, soil fertility, types of soil, etc. Now come to the human geography. The human geography, as its name suggests, is basically concerning about the humans. In the beginning, this is more about where the man is lived. But in the recent years, the economic activities and the environmental concerns had got more attention in human geography. But still, its main concern or the focus area is about the people who are living in different lands or in different regions. If we divide the human geography in subdivisions, the first comes the social and the cultural geography. The social or the cultural geography is mainly concerned to the spatial of society's dynamic as well as the elements of culture which are contributed to society. Next, the population and settlement geography. The population geography is mainly concerned to the population density, population growth, age structure, sex ratio, and other variables which are affecting the population. And the settlement geography is mainly concerned to the rural and the urban settlement. Next, to the economic geography. Economic geography is related to all the economic activities including agriculture, trade, communication, and all the economic activities which affect the economic development of the country. Historical geography. All regions has passed through some historical development. So in the historical geography, we studied about the historical events or the historical background of the geography. Next, the political geography. In political geography, we look at the angle of political events, like what are the political events that are affecting the geography of any country. It concerns about the boundaries of the national or the international boundaries, delimitations of constituencies, etc. Next, the biogeography. The interface between the physical geography and human geography has led to the development of biogeography. We can say it is the hybrid geography, or where we found the characteristics of physical and human geography both. If we divide the biogeography, it includes the plant geography, which mainly considered to the spatial patterns of the natural vegetations in their habitat. While concerning to the zoo geography, it mainly concerned to the spatial and the geographical patterns of the animals and natural vegetation in their habitat. Ecosystem or the ecology, it has given some scientific dealing to the geography where we concern the interaction of human and the physical environment. In environmental geography, we studies about the environmental issues and the environmental concerns that are affecting the geography of any region or any state of any country. Now, the domains of geography based on regional approach. We can divide domains of geography on basis of the regional approach. The regional studies area, which is further divided into micro, meso or macro. The regional development, the regional analysis and the regional planning is again subdivided into the country or the rural planning, town and the urban planning. We can say that in regional geography, we studies about the regional studies or the area studies, which is divided into the macro, micro and the meso regions. In regional planning, we discuss about to the planning of any region. Regional development and regional analysis is all are the part of regional geography, in where we study how to develop the region, how to contribute in the development of region. Besides the above mentioned approaches, geography is further divided based on the thought and methodologies. Geography, if we divide on the basis of principles and philosophy, there is a geographical thought and human ecology and land and human thought. And if we concern about the method and the techniques, it could be divided as cartographic, quantitative methods, field survey or geoinformatics. Geoinformatics further divided in remote sensing, GIS and GPS. Welcome on the philosophy. Any subject or any social science subject has different philosophy. So here is the geography. So geography thought. There can be different thoughts, there can be different geographical thought who can be help in studying the geography. In geographical thought, we basically studied about the evolution of geography, historical background of geography, and what are the historical thoughts about the geographical evolution. Second, regarding the philosophy, we studied about the land and human interaction or the human ecology. As I have already told about in the characteristics of geography, that land and human interaction or the human or the environment interaction is a very important part of studying the geography. Next, geography based on the thought and methodologies, it can be further divided as cartography including computer cartography, quantitative techniques or we can say the statistical methods, field survey methods or the geoinformatics comprising technologies such as remote sensing, GIS or GPS, etc. These all methods and techniques are basically used to collect the data, to interpret the data and to analyze the data. If we think or if we talk about the development of geography, we can see that geography is developing more and more from the classical approach to the digitalization of internet and the other media like remote sensing, GIS and GPS and GIS are the more modern techniques to interpret the data. I hope you all students have understood this session and satisfied with this lecture. Thank you.